I want to give a big thank you, because this series of videos has been pretty good, pretty well received so far, and I am so happy to see it, because these kinds of videos are the ones that I think are the most interesting, so it makes me happy to see that people are receptive to this series. The James Neal video the other day was really well received, but today we're talking about a trade that's a lot more complicated than the James Neal trade. Let's go back over to 2018. Yeah, that's right. This is back in September of 2018, so we're approaching the 3-year anniversary of this trade right here. And, you know, out of all the ones we've discussed so far, JT Miller, Thomas Tatar, James Neal as well, this is by far the most complicated trade that we're gonna dissect and take a look at how all the trade details have been finalized. So, let's talk about it right here. Erik Karlsson. The Karlsson trade, which sent the Ottawa Senators captain, and at the time considered one of the best offensive defensemen we had seen in the NHL in this generation, over to the San Jose Sharks for a boatload of stuff. Now, the big thing about the Karlsson trade when it happened was that everybody thought, oh my gosh, the Sens, they absolutely got fleeced. Are you kidding me? There's no big-name player coming back in this Senators package. The Ottawa Senators traded away Erik Karlsson, a franchise defenseman who was, admittedly, in a contract year, so you could debate his value was reduced by quite a little bit, and Francis Perron to the San Jose Sharks for Josh Norris, Chris Tierney, Rudolph Spalzers, Dylan DeMello, a 2019 second, a 2019 or 2020 conditional first, a 2021 conditional first or second, and a 2022 conditional first. Now, you can see there are three conditional picks involved in this trade, which is kind of why it's now only being solidified how everything went down, because it's 2021 and all the conditions, they have either been fulfilled or denied, therefore rejected or held up. So, let's go over what exactly the conditions were. This is what it says here on NHLTradeTracker.com. The 2019 second rounder, which is this pick right here, is the better of San Jose's own or Florida's own, previously acquired. If the Sharks miss the playoffs in 2018-19, the 19 or 20 first rounder will be in 2019. Otherwise, it's a 2020 first round pick that will go to Ottawa should the Sharks make the playoffs in 2019. That in which did happen. The Sharks made the 2019 Stanley Cup playoffs. They had themselves a fantastic first round where they were down 3-1 to the Vegas Golden Knights. They tied the series up, and then in Game 7, they were down even further before coming back and winning in overtime. So, the Sharks, yeah, there's that fulfillment right there. They made the playoffs in 2019, therefore, the pick that was sent over to Ottawa in the trade was a 2020 first from San Jose. If the Sharks re-sign Erik Karlsson, which they did, the Sens would also receive another second-round pick in 2021, which would become a first-round pick if the Sharks make it to the Stanley Cup Final in 2019. They didn't make the finals in 2019, they lost to the inevitable champion St. Louis Blues Club. Albeit it was in the third round, so they were close, but still, that condition was not fulfilled. Therefore, the 2021 first or second remained as a 2021 second. That pick, by the way, is officially why this trade is now complete. The final pick right here that is listed, a 2022 conditional first, was just insurance. If Erik Karlsson was on an Eastern Conference team anytime during the 2018-19 season, the Sharks would have to send to Sens an additional first-round pick no later than 2022. They did this because they didn't want to have another Mike Hoffman situation where the Sens are like, okay, we don't want to trade Hoffman to a team in the East, so we'll trade him to San Jose. And then San Jose trades Hoffman immediately to Florida, like 2 minutes after, and then the Sens reply like, okay, what the hell, San Jose? We didn't want Hoffman in this division. That's why we traded him to you. You guys suck, man. So that's why that last one was there. It wasn't fulfilled because Karlsson remained with the Sharks. But now, all of the picks have been officially established, and the way things have gone down, it is indeed set. From here, you can kind of infer where things went down. Francis Perron stuck around with San Jose. I always kind of liked what he was able to bring in the AHL, although he never really broke out into a full-time role in the NHL. He spent some time with the Vancouver system as well. Today, though, he is currently a free agent. Erik Karlsson is a player who, come on, you know who Erik Karlsson is. He's been injured a bit, he's got a big money contract, and he is declining point production-wise year by year, which is not good, but continuing on. Over to the Ottawa Senators, though, this is kind of where the meat is on the bone. Dylan DeMello was pretty okay with the Sens, I would think. Now he's in Winnipeg, though. He had 9 points in 50-something games played last season. Chris Tierney stuck around with the Senators, had 19 points in 55 games last season. He's going to be sticking around next year as well. He's going to be signed for one more season at 3.5 AAV, so we'll see where exactly he goes in his career after this season. Rudolph's Balzers is interesting because he became a free agent and he actually re-signed with San Jose, where he had 17 points in 41 games played this previous year. So, interesting for them to go ahead and get that asset back. Then you have Josh Norris, who was traded over as the big fish, you could say, in this deal. It was the signing rights for him at the time, and the Ottawa Senators, they latched onto that guy, used him in the AHL, he was fantastic, and then in his full rookie season with the Sens this year, 35 points, 56 games played. Norris is only 22 years old, and he's got one more year in his rookie contract. He's definitely a really interesting piece, and a lot of Senators fans are really hoping that Josh Norris becomes what we believe he can be, because if he does pan out and he reaches his ceiling, he could be a very legit top 6 forward at the NHL level. Now, this is where things get a little bit interesting. The very first pick that the Ottawa Senators received, that they actually used in this trade, was the 2019 second-round pick. This pick was originally Florida's, and it was acquired by San Jose in the Mike Hoffman trade. The condition for the 2019 second was the Senators would receive the higher of San Jose's second or Florida's second. Florida's was higher, so it went to Ottawa. However, this pick was not actually used by the Senators, as the Senators traded this pick, as well as a 2019 third-round pick from the Penguins, to the Carolina Hurricanes in exchange for the 37th overall pick, selecting Mads Søgaard, who is a pretty capable goaltending prospect who was really strong with Belleville last year. So the Sens traded up in the 2019 draft to draft Mads Søgaard using one of the picks they acquired in the Erik Karlsson trade. The next picks, they actually used themselves. The 2020 first-round pick was a doozy, because this one was granted to Ottawa because the Sharks made the playoffs in 2019. It would have been their 2020 first, which was sent over to Ottawa, but unbeknownst to the San Jose Sharks at the time, they would suck in the 2019-20 season. They were terrible, they finished as one of the worst teams in the league, and as a result, the Ottawa Senators received the third overall pick in 2020, taking Tim Stutzle, who... yeah, you don't need me to tell you who he is. He's the next Pavel Bure. Okay, not going to talk about that. We've discussed Stutzle several times on this channel, but lo and behold, he is a fantastic young NHL star, electrifying player with 90-plus point potential, in my opinion. Is he the next Pavel Bure? Probably not, but still, he's fantastic, and there is nothing to discredit him and the way that he is going to develop in the long term. The 2021 second-round pick, though, was the final pick that solidified this trade, pretty much. Take a look at the conditions. This was the Senators receiving the Sharks' 2021 second-round pick if Karlsson was re-signed. This was the pick that would have upgraded to a first had the Sharks reached the Stanley Cup Finals in 2019, that in which they did not because they were eliminated in 6 games to the Blues. This 2021 pick was used by the Senators to select Zach Ostapchuk, 39th overall, in the 2021 NHL Entry Draft. Now, Ostapchuk is interesting. He's 6'3", 205, a big guy playing for the Vancouver Giants. He had 16 points in 22 games this most previous season. And, you know, a lot of people in the scouting community were honestly pretty high on Ostapchuk. Not because he was elite Connor McDavid or whatever, but because for a big guy who played in a pretty small-ish kind of league, he knew how to use his size and he knew how to use his skating to make some really good things happen on the ice. You can see the big improvement in production from his rookie season in the WHL to his previous season. He had 8 points in 44 games in 2019-20, 16 points in 22 games the next season, so he doubled the production in half the games. That's a really good projection over there for a guy that's just going to get better at the WHL level as he goes on, so the Senators taking a swing on this guy from a draft pick that they acquired 3 years ago is indeed a pretty nice gift. So if you take a look at the trade right here, the actual conditions go as follows. The Ottawa Senators traded away a declining Erik Karlsson who needed a contract, Francis Perron who is currently a free agent, as well as the Pittsburgh Penguins' third round pick in exchange for Dylan DeMello, who is in Winnipeg, Chris Tierney, who is still with the Sens, Rudolph's Balzers, who is now in San Jose again, Josh Norris, who is fantastic, Mads Søgaard, who is a fantastic goaltending prospect, Tim Stutzle, who you know who he is, as well as Zach Ostapchuk. The Sens ultimately made two trades to solidify these results over here. Firstly, of course, the Karlsson trade with San Jose, and secondly, the Mads Sogard trade, which was essentially a moving up kind of trade with the Carolina Hurricanes in the 2019 draft. It's two trades right here condensed into one video. Talk to me in the comments what you think about this entire package over here. Sure, any of these guys could get traded, but the way things have gone down now with all the draft picks and whatnot, it's all been solidified. This is the finalized Erik Karlsson trade return. I hope you enjoyed the special Ash Rolls in 99. And bye.